I hope you've enjoyed the day today with the story about Pebble and all the things that go with Pebble and all the activities that we've done about what things feel soft and prickly and all that sort of thing. So here's a bedtime story for you to end the day. And it's called Bedtime for Pebble. We'll find out what happens. Our Pebble, who had been in school, got painted red and felt, oh, so cool, was taken back in a teacher's car to the beach she loved. It wasn't far. The teacher left her on the sand in a warm, sunny spot, and Pebble felt grand. She had done what pebbles never do, an exciting time that felt so new. So now it was time at the end of the day to settle down in a quiet way and go to sleep until the sun would shine in the sky and the night was done. Our Pebble tossed and turned in the sea, but although she tried, she couldn't get comfy. She thought about the things she'd done and simply couldn't stop the fun that zoomed around inside her head. And now she couldn't sleep. She'd forgotten how. The waves were trying to soothe her, and they swished her back and forth in sea and sand. And then in the distance, walking along, was a little girl skipping and singing a song about tide rolling out and in, how we love to splash and swim. The girl was having a walk before tea, and her favourite walk was by the sea. She nearly put her foot right down on Pebble, lying on the ground, but instead she picked Pebble up high, and she turned her over and gave a sigh. I think you should be going to sleep and dreaming of your time on this lovely beach. Pebbles don't talk, so she couldn't tell the girl that it's difficult to sleep when your mind's in a whirl. The girl said, well, it looks like if you can't close your eyes, so I've brought you a bed. Shall we give it a try? Well, Pebble nearly squealed in surprise and delight. She could rest under seaweed in bed for a night. So the little girl popped Pebble into the bed and sang a song. Go to sleep, sleepy head. Pebble's eyes closed and she started to snore. Very quietly whispered, so this is what beds are for. Our Pebble slept soundly until break of day, when the tide picked her up and swept her away to play in the waves and the sea and the sun. Pebble was rested and happy and so full of fun. Maybe one day I'll go back to school and be red, but each night I will tuck myself under seaweed in my own special bed. And I'm going to show you. Here she is. Pebble is fast asleep in her own special bed. She's not awake, she's fast asleep. Just like you need to go to sleep now, thinking of Pebble and all the lovely things you've done today.